Hey guys, what's up? This is Max. Today I'm going to do something different. I'm going to unbox my new MacBook Pro with a Retina display, but it's not the new one.
You did it again, man.
That sounds good.
You know, I've been waiting for a long time for some shit like this, you know what I mean? You got me going out like.
White boy, but I still get my swag on. Skinny man, but I still get my shag on. Woman always trying to get me here to settle down. Y'all already know I never let it drag on. They always want it, so I gotta let them work for it. Good things come quick when you search for it. If you praying and you hoping that you make it big, it won't happen if you only go to church for it. I don't come with that junk. I just come with that flow. I just come with the truth. The truth is something I know. I'm just a man in the six, trying to make paper, trying to make dough. If I don't make the cake that I want, I'ma just take the cake that I own. Started with Nike kicks and white tees. Now I rock black Vans in my shows, mixed with the black pants to my toes. I'm like the Pac-Man, y'all the ghost. Always trying to catch me up in my maze, but I'm too fast, I know y'all agree. Everybody wanna gas up and get paid, but they ain't doing shit, they sitting on E.
I want to give you some reasons why I didn't purchase the new MacBook Pro with the touch bar. So I collected a couple of tweets about the new MacBook Pro. With the touch bar, and I gotta say, I don't like it. I don't like that you have to carry so many adapters with you just to get an SD card into it. And I really depend on SD cards because of the videos, and I don't want to carry so many adapters on every journey, on every day trip with me just because I need them with the new MacBook Pro. I like that the old MacBook Pro had all these normal USB slots, Thunderbolt slots and so on, and it was really easy just to use it right on the go. You didn't have to think about what accessories do you need to carry and what not. And it's also kinda expensive, so for the MacBook that I purchased, I would have to pay another $700 just to get the latest version. So that's why I purchased the MacBook Pro from 2015, the 15-inch model, because I got the 13-inch model from 2013. And I would really just like to get my hands on a beautiful device which has so much power. So I think the 2015 version is just the best one for me because it has the dedicated graphics card and it just has so much to offer for me because I don't have to think about all these dongles. And these dongles are also quite expensive. I would need to invest like about $100 at least to get the MacBook that I want right away. But I just saved all the money and purchased this 2015 model, which is totally fine. I think it will work for many years fine for me and maybe for you as well. And I think the touch bar, which you saw in the recent tweets that I showed you, is just useless at the moment. I mean, maybe it will become useful. Maybe the developers will really engage with it and will find nice ways to really enhance some functionality and add some cool features with the touch bar, and maybe it will really enhance our actual workflow. But at the moment I see that there are so many bugs, and I see that there are so many problems with it, and that there is no real need to look down on your keyboard for this touch bar, but you just want to look on your usual display. You don't want to look down on your keys. I mean, we just want to look at the display, look at our designs and what we ever consume right now on the display. We don't want to look down. I mean, it's totally annoying to look down on my keyboard because maybe I didn't find a key that I wanted to press. That's annoying, and we have moved beyond that like many years ago. Now we are stepping back to look down again on our keyboard. Now I think that's strange. I think that's a step back, and I think Apple did a lot of steps back in the last few years. But these are my few reasons why I just wanted to stick with the MacBook from 2015, 15-inch model, beautiful design, which isn't that minimal because it has some slots. It has USB slots. It has an SD card slot, which is the stuff I need. I mean, I need it. I don't want to carry around like two or three adapters every day just to be able to use my device as I'm used to it for the last, say, like 10 years or something like that. I think you will probably understand this, and many other designers and tech people are also supporting this. This was today's episode, somehow different from the rest of this. I hope you still enjoy this creative everyday series, which is fun to me because it's different, and I want to just pause these tutorials for the December and to just focus on real life, focus on family, and take you with me on these cool trips and journeys. I just want to be able to create something creative every day and to film it and to show it to you guys, because I want to just say thanks. I owe a lot to you, and you are just a great community. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you like my opinion about the MacBook Pro. If you support the MacBook Pro with Touch Bar, just write it down in the comments and maybe let me know what you like about it. So I think this could really like help us a lot, and we could like have a nice conversation there, and I'm really looking forward to that. So thank you for your time and see you. Ain't doing shit, they ain't shitting on me. I'ma go big till I'm whipping on three, with a crib in the south and a house in the hills, with a bitch in the pool while I'm sipping on tea. Got big dreams that I put in my head. Every damn working harder to grow. Never got love and it died as a kid, but as days go by, man, it's starting to show. I know one day I'll get a call from a man, and he'll probably say it's regarding the flow. Like